Even to this date in India, similar great water bath like structures are there where the water is collected and it flows from the mouth of the cow, and you can see the steps are there. And the steps, it is not that the steps are all are covered with water, but the lowest one are left over. And in the people, they go down the stairs and then they take a dip into the holy water. And this is something very similar like baptization, which was very likely done at the great water bath. Very same idea is executed in the great water bath of Mohenjo-daro by making the steps. Instead of lotus, they have the steps. Now if you count, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the ninth step is the water bath itself. So what happens for the holy procedure? It's very likely that the great bath was made as a place for holy dip. That gives us freedom from the mortal body, and that's how it can also called a place of liberation, or as they say in Hinduism, Hari Dwar, that is the gateway to liberation, to the Hari form. Walks into the holy water through the 8 steps and then have the dip in the 9th one, that is the pool itself. One has the holy dip and the holy sip, and at the same time he walks to the other side being purified of with all the 9 spiritual centers. One walk over and climb the 8 steps, which symbolizes that one has been purified and now can walk onto the Mohenjo-daro holy dome.